Year of Patreon, dude.
Dude, this is a special month. We are celebrating an entire year of Patreon, as well as over 1,000 subs on Patreon.
Dude, we're almost at like 1,400.
All right, well, over 1,000. So basically, we're going to do something crazy for this month. We're going through all of Zeppelin 4 in its entirety.
Yeah, it'd be my first time hearing it.
Yeah, so we're going to start to finish the entire album. Not only are we doing that, we're also throwing some extra sauce in there. And we're doing L.A. Woman by The Doors.
Layla by Eric Clapton and Derek and the Dominoes.
Dude, it's going to be a crazy month.
And once we hit 2,000 Patreons,
which is not going to be long,
we are going to record and release a cover for you guys here on YouTube. And the people on Patreon will vote in which song we do.
Yeah, so with that being said, all this for $1. If you want to get in it, get in it. If not, your video's coming up.
Hey guys, hope you're having a great day as well as a great life.
Some new bands this week. And I'm excited for one.
Toto.
I've seen it all over the comments.
Absolutely.
I think we both heard of the song Africa just because it was really meme-y for a while.
Yeah, and just at bars.
Yeah. But it was really popular for a while as like a meme or a GIF where people were just like spreading it around. I don't know why it got so popular.
Dude, it has like 700 million plays on Spotify.
Yeah, and I know a bunch of those happened. Like, it was already a big song.
Yeah.
And I think it got rediscovered by like today's youth and it blew up even more.
Absolutely.
So it had like two peaks. I wonder how many like of the 700 million came from the second peak.
Facts.
Yeah.
I think it's super interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Either way. So we're not doing that one because we've kind of heard of it, even though we haven't listened to it all the way through. And maybe we should. Maybe we'll do a live version or something. But today we're doing Hold the Line. Sounds cool. Sounds strong.
I'm ready for a fierce song.
I don't know what they're going to sound like, but I'm interested to find out. With that being said, let's get into it. Ooh.
Oh, dude.
Okay, dude, I dig this. Oh, wait. That's cool.
I think I've heard this. I think.
The swung feel is so cool.
Yeah, I've heard this. Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Great build up.
That dynamic shift, dude. Love isn't always on time. Oh, oh, oh. For the line.
Love isn't always on time. Oh, oh, oh. Wow, cool. Cool scales.
Wow.
Oh, dude.
God, that's really good at vocal track.
Wow. Holy God. It's not in the way that your love set me free. It's not in the way you look or the things that you say that you do. For the line. Love isn't always on time. Oh, oh, this song rips. For the line.
Kind of Michael Jackson.
Dude, I don't think the guitar solo had to, like, no one asked it to rip that hard.
Okay,
but it ripped
so
that hard.
Here's my deal.
What's your deal?
So this feels like an 80s song. I don't know when it was released, but yeah. It feels 80s in a way that is not unpleasant to me at all.
Feels timeless, dude.
At
feels timeless.
All, dude.
Definitely, like, had heard this before, by the way, just so you guys know.
Oh, you had? Yeah.
Absolutely.
Dude, this sounded so good. There was no aspect of this song that I did not enjoy. Yeah. I loved the swung feel of the drums. The drummer was great. The singer, absolutely incredible.
Yeah,
it was crazy. Would have never guessed that Toto could, like, because I'd only heard Africa. So it's like, how do you go from Africa, which is also a great song, but it's not
this is like different level.
This is next level.
Like, all I recalled was like the chorus kind of, and then like the kind of the way it started, it felt like reminiscent in some fashion. But I definitely hadn't heard the whole song, and like, just all these different things that they did, all these little details that when you really listen to it, it's insane. Like, I just knew it as, oh yeah, it's that song with that chorus, you know?
Yeah, it's real good.
The guitar solo, dude, it came in super tasteful.
So had you heard the guitar solo?
No, dude.
Oh, so you just heard
just like the chorus and kind of like the way the beat fell in a little bit in the beginning.
Okay. Like the swung, okay.
Yeah, but I was not ready for that guitar solo. I didn't know, and when it started, I thought it was going to be kind of like an 80s-esque guitar solo where it kind of, oh, we're going to add this melodic feel, and then we're going to go right back into the song. It's going to be like 8 bars max.
No, this was extended.
It ripped.
What's killer about this is it felt like an 80s anthem. And if it's not in the 80s, then it's ahead of its time. I'd hazard to guess it's in the 80s.
Yeah.
But it felt like it was ahead of its time regardless. Because it's not using the weird 80s production that I'm not fond of, that I think is kind of looked back on with somewhat poor light.
Yeah.
But it was taking the great style of the chorus where they have all those layered vocals, like the really high, like gang vocally stuff, and all the harmonies with it. Just phenomenally done. The style of the chorus. Like, they took the best part of the 80s and brought it to the max. And then not only did they write a catchy hit song, but they also were like, no, we're also going to show incredible musicianship, put a guitar solo that could fit in a Van Halen song. Well, I mean, Van Halen was also that time period, but like that could compete with pretty much any other guitar solo. That was phenomenal.
Very intense. It was so very well structured. And it had like a climax that didn't feel like it was trying so hard to be a climax. It felt like a natural, genuine just climax of, you know, music.
Yeah, and I gotta be honest. It sometimes is weird to feel like the swung feel in rock and roll music. Just because sometimes it, like, rock and roll is so driven, and sometimes I find it's hard to, when I hear songs that do that, to get the same punch as you can, like just a straight groove. They did so well with it.
Absolutely.
So well. So yeah, the groove was great. They had so much energy in it. It was so lively. The production, I had no qualms about the production elements.
Yeah, and in terms of just like, it's a radio song. It's a commercial song, but this just pulls, like you said, all those best elements from the 80s and packages it in a way that's not cheesy, corny, and it comes off as timeless. I feel like you could play this almost any point. Just in the way, like, the vocalists, they have him tastefully dig in every so often and stuff.
Phenomenal.
And the way in certain sections, like, the way that just the rhythm would go, all these instruments would pull back, but you would just hear the piano. Dun, 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 dun.
This shows that you can write a hit song without compromising on a good song.
Yeah.
And I think that's what they did here.
I feel like they didn't sacrifice, like, creatively.
Anything. They didn't sacrifice anything.
It felt like they tastefully put everything together.
Yeah.
Okay, so how are we going to rate this, dude? I mean, I feel like in terms of like an 80s commercially type song, I feel like I don't know how much better it can get than this.
I don't know if I can. Yeah. So I'll tell you this, easily A+. The question is it an S tier song?
I think if I'm going for this vibe, if I'm driving, you know, with my girlfriend, I want like an 80s type of song with that vibe, I think this is in the top 5, like contender, or top 3 even, in most situations, or it's like, it'll at least be like a safe pick for that vibe.
I don't think you're wrong, dude. I'm trying to think of where I could maybe say something. I think, but no, I do. I think as far as 80 songs go, now they're gonna. If yeah. it's not an 80 song, we're gonna get ripped. But either way, dude, I think it was either ahead of its time or it was the pinnacle of its time. And either way, dude, I think this is an S tier song.
I think S in terms Dang. Of like, and that's not like S of all music that we've heard, but in terms of this, like
what corner, they were going for,
this part of music, this section, this like yeah. land, their flag is down.
Yeah, this is their flag territory. Is
proud. It's waving in the wind. No, I think S on this.
Wow, dude, that was awesome.
Fantastic Woo! Song.
All right, well, what do we do by them next? Because obviously they've got sauce.
I don't want to do Africa only because I know how it's going to end up.
That's true.
Because I've at least heard the chorus, and I don't think it'll be a situation like this song where I've heard the chorus, and I'm going to be blown away by all these other things.
Yeah.
I'm sure it's a great song, but I feel like it's just going to be us smiling along to Africa.
Yeah, I think we'll get to the end, we'll be like, oh, it's cool. It feels like Africa.
I feel like there's been at least two or three occasions in a bar where I'm tipsy, like, to Africa. You know, yeah. So I feel like I've already done that. You know what I'm saying?
I've already done
but, that. But no, Toto, this was a great start for this group. Yeah. If they have more sauce, phenomenal. Let us know down below.
Yeah, comment down. We'll see you next video.